ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपकदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं। वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरोर्श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरोर्नवैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं सग्रजातं सहगणरघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगणललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च। नमः ओम विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामये। नमस्ते सारस्वती देवे गौरवाणि प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादि पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधो दीनबंधो जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते। जयतां सुरतो पंगो मम मंदमतिर्गति मत्सर्वस्य पदाम्भोजो राधा मदर मोहनो दिव्य वृंदारण्य कल्पद्रुमादः श्रीमद् रत्नागार सिंहासनस्थो श्रीमद् राधा श्रील गोविंद देवो प्रेष्ठालिभि सेव्यमानो स्मरामि। श्रीमान रासरसारंभे वंशी वट तटस्थितः कर्षन वेणु स्वनिर्गोपी गोपीनाथ श्रीयस्तु नः। तप्त कांचन गौरांगे राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये। नमो महावदन्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरत्विषे नमः। पंचतत्वात्मकं कृष्णं भक्तरूपस्वरूपकं भक्तावतारं भक्ताख्यं नमामि भक्तशक्तिकं। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। We'll get into the third story, that is this is story of ultimate truth and the story of detachment, that is Krishna's returning to his spiritual place. So now we'll see, having sent Uddhava on his behalf, what Krishna did and how he left to his spiritual place. As such, in this world many people oppose Krishna and they oppose God and they say that there is no God. There are some people who accept God, but they say that God cannot have form, and they say that when God comes he has to be bound by the Trigunas. They say like that. They try to, whatever is applicable to them, they try to apply to God also. So they are also like a demonstration. Demons say that there is no God, but these people accept the God and they try to impose whatever is applicable to him to God also. And for such people, from the beginning Krishna is a big question mark, is a big confusion, because they never comprehend how a small, like even Muhyanti Asuraya. Even when the demigods are getting confused about Krishna's activity, what to talk about the demons? But when you say that, oh, Krishna at the age of 7, he has lifted the big Govardhana hill, oh, how it is possible? So they cannot go. It's a big confusion. And Krishna says, yes, Krishna expanded into the innumerable forms and he just played with, had a wonderful dance with the gopis. They cannot go. Because every activity of Krishna gives them big dilemma, question mark, how it is possible. So in that way they all thinking, get lost. So Krishna somehow makes them also, that they are constantly thinking about him, how it is possible, they have to get delivered, purified. That is Krishna's idea. If Krishna's activity is easily comprehensible, they would have really defied him. They punched him and like that. But the activities are slow. So we can see that even he returning to Godhead, because they have strong feeling that yadrishyam tannashyam, whatever you have seen, it has to get lost. So Krishna's form is seen, so form has to get lost. That is their logic. So even they cannot comprehend how Krishna's form can be lost. It cannot be possible. So from the first to second of birth of living back to the spiritual world, Krishna's activities will be very, very confusing for the demonic people. So let us see how he made the return to his spiritual world more confusing to the all the demonic people. Then when he has sent the activity, it so happened because by the Krishna's arrangement itself, the people started looking, great some indications of danger are appearing, where they see that danger is appearing in the sky, and they are seeing on the earth also so many unwanted things happening, and even in antariksha also. So everywhere they say, oh, something is going to happen, because now each and every person in the Dwaraka, they know that Yadavas, they got the curse. Curse is that all the Yadu dynasty will die, they get lost, but they don't know what happens afterwards. They have no idea. The further entire script is written by Krishna. Entire plan is done by Krishna. He only knows how to do it, where to do it, when to do it, with whom to be done, everything. But everybody knows it is God. So in that way, when he saw that great utpata, utpata eva kalpa, there are so many utpatas happening everywhere. Then he arranged a conference in the Sudharma and said that now that all this appearing, I am instructing you, let us do it. We should not stay even for next one moment here. Let all the ladies, children, old people be sent to the Shankodhara. The place is called Shankodhara. Let all people go there and get stay safe there. And whereas we go to Prabhasa, we all will go to Prabhasa because children, they should not be with us. Children, old people and ladies, they should not be with us. Let entire people, because in the Dwaraka, not only Yadu dynasty, there are other people also, who are the followers of, many people are there. So he segregated. Let Yadavas come to Prabhas Tirtha, old people, children and the children and ladies, they all go to Shankha Tirtha. And he said that we'll go to that place of Prabhasa Tirtha, and Prabhasa is a very pious place. So there's every possibility that we take some corrective action, antidote. Antidote will take it so that the curse will be eliminated. So when Krishna himself is saying curse can be eliminated, everybody became enthusiastic. Okay, let's go there. And he says that we'll go there and we'll perform the pujas and we'll feed the brahmanas, we'll do the abhisheka, like that, all the activities, and we'll give the donations, cow donation, like that, everything. So they immediately arrange hundreds and thousands of ships and they all travel, and the entire thing is vacated almost. Only few people are left, like Ugrasena, Vasudeva, Devaki, like the internal people only left. Krishna's wives were there inside, and remaining all, entire thing, they all vacated. So all the Yadu dynasty, they all traveled to Prabhasa Tirtha. Krishna, Balaram, they all traveled to Prabhasa Tirtha, and other people, children, old people and ladies, they also came, but they went to the Shankha Tirtha. So in that way, when Krishna proposed a big plan, everybody, yes, let it be so, tathastu. And they got it and they went there. Very sincere, because everybody is fearful. And when the fear is there, people will follow instructions. No, because they have no option. So they become very sincere. Whatever Krishna said, everybody started doing. They started doing, and they do it with all the dharma, all religious activities, with all sincerity they did. With all sincerity they did it, and they do the Mangala Karya, they did Dana, and By the providence, as arranged by Krishna, they took a drink called Maireya. Maireya they took. Is a beverage which gives intoxication. But by providence, they took unlimited quantity. That not only one, everybody took it. Krishna's sons, grandsons, Yadu, everybody took. Everybody took. And the moment they intoxicated, they started quarreling with each other. First is the quarreling means by epta. Quarreling, small quarrel started. And that quarrel went, and going in a fraction of seconds, going up, because everything happened just in few hours' time, not that it went for days together. So then they started quarreling and they started fighting. Everybody took their weapons. Everybody took a weapons and they immediately took different carriers also. Somebody started on the elephant, somebody on the chariot, somebody on the human, somebody on the monkey, somebody on the donkeys, and the camels, everything. Started fighting. Amusing fighting. With whom is fighting? Like Prajumna is fighting with Samba. Just imagine. Prajumna is the son of Kunti, Rukmini, and Samba is the son of Jambavati. Fighting. So Miss Krishna's sons. Just one example is given. Just imagine. One to one, because these two names are Akrura is fighting with Kunti Bhoja, Aniruddha is fighting with Satyaki. Satyaki is their chariot driver, is all well-wisher, and Krishna's grandson is fighting with him. And Subhadra is fighting with Sangramajit, Sumitra is fighting Suratha. In that way, by Krishna's Maya, they are fighting. They are fighting. And in this way, Dashahra, Vrishni, Antaka, Bhoja, Satvata, Madhu, Arbuda, Mathura, Shurasena, Visarja, Kukura, Kunta. Various clans are there. They all originally came to support Krishna. All demigods, they appeared. They were all staying in the Dwaraka and they all came. Some relation is there, some connection. And they all started fighting with each other. And many are dead. And meanwhile, their weapons also broken. Now there are no weapons also. So they were thinking what to do. Suddenly, their eyes fell on the sharp grass which grown on the banks of the ocean, which actually the powder, the musala. Which has been made into powder has been pushed into the water, and all it just came to the banks and they got converted into a sharp grass. And they all felt that it is only grass, long grass, but they felt that it is something by the providence. They all just pulled out. As they pulled out, they became the strongest weapon. Because that is the final, because that is the that has been produced because of by curse. That all the Brahmana says, the curse is that the one which is going to really, the curse, the Brahmana's curse is that the musala which is going to destroy the whole Yadu dynasty is going to be delivered by Samba. That was the answer. So unless they catch that, there cannot be final destruction, cannot happen. The moment they caught it, they became like a thunderbolt. Everybody is having thunderbolt. With that they started. And at that time Krishna and Balaram went and to stop them, and they started attacking them. Just imagine how much, you can't imagine that how Krishna designed, and how it is beyond explanation that they are seeing that the Supreme Master, he has protected every time. And when Krishna and Balaram went there to stop, they attacked even him. So Krishna Balaram has no option than also to hold that grass, which converted into, the moment they held it, it has become like a thunderbolt. So they started killing all people. So people started killing themselves. Those who are left over are killed by Krishna. Just imagine. And entire samhara karya has finally happened because by the invincible chapa, the curse of Brahmana. And of course, everything happened because of the Krishna's inconceivable plan. And he felt that, and he ensured that everything is executed in his presence by him. And when each and every Yadu was finally dead, only two are left over, that is Krishna and Balaram. Remaining all people, and it is mentioned that almost 56 crores of Yadus, 56 crores of people are completely dead in no time. 56 crores dead, as per the shastra. So, once that is done, Balaram went to the banks of the ocean and he sat in meditation. He sat in meditation and he started meditating on the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and then he disappeared immediately from that place. And he left this material world and he entered into the eternal action as a Sankarsana for assisting Krishna's pastime. Then when Lord Krishna saw that the Swamsha Balarama left this planet and he has gone to his spiritual world, then he went to a nearby place, a small, like a forest place is there, very, very, very close to the place where these crores of people are dead. Went to the place and saw a small Ashwatthavruksha. Ashwatthavruksha generally very big, but this Ashwatthavruksha was surprisingly a small Ashwatthavruksha. He just sat down below that, leaning onto the trunk. So when he was sitting there, he immediately transformed into a 400 form. Not only that, all his weapons he starts seeing as a 400 form, and Shankha, Chakra, Gada, Padma, all these weapons, they got personified. Means they all appeared as a persons. So he appeared to be surrounded by various great personalities. And he is shining like a smokeless fire. And his eyes are very clean and looking, and he is very attractive. And he kept his left leg on the right thigh. And in that way, his soul is being seen. So it is felt a hunter by name Jara, long distance he saw the soul of the Krishna, that is the lower part of his leg, as the face of a deer. It appeared to him because his lotus feet is like a reddish. So he has shot an arrow and he felt that he hit the arrow, he hit the goal. He felt, but actually it did not happen. So it is clearly mentioned in Bhagavatam that he felt that he hit the target. And he came to see that, but he did not see anything such happened. But his arrow is there and the Supreme Personality. Then he immediately fell down at his lotus feet, and of course he spoke elaborately, that saying that he did an offense by trying to hit him at, and Uttama Shloka, he asked for the pardon, and he said that before he does commit many such offenses, he requested Krishna to kill him out. Please kill me so that I will not be making such offenses, because you are the personality. Simply by remembering you, that once again, the darkness of the ignorance gets destroyed. So I tried to make some offense with you. So please kill me. So the acharyas they tried to explain, like Sri Vishnuchakravarti Thakur, that this scene is also created by Krishna. Just imagine that a hunter coming almost the actually by time all the people are killed, it became very very evening, the sunset almost happening, and there are 56 crores of dead bodies happening there, and at that time that such a ghastly scene, somebody is going for hunting a deer, and a deer also happening within that, so much happening, it is not just possible, it just not possible. And also it should not be, and also the Bhagavatam also clearly stating that the Jara felt that he hit the target, and but Krishna, when this the hunter said, Krishna said only one, my dear, don't worry, don't fear, it just wait, you please get up, and it's all happened because of my plan, it has happened just as I planned and as I desired, only it has happened, so I am blessing you to go to the spiritual world where the Sukriti one, they can go, you please try. And he has sent him Sasharira, with the same body he went to that this Jara has made parikrama to Krishna, and three times, and the moment he has finished, a beautiful aeroplane, a divine aeroplane arrived there, and the Jara, who just sat down, went and disappeared to spiritual world. And meanwhile, Krishna's chariot driver, his name is Daruka. Daruka was searching, where is my master, because he came, he saw that all the people are dead, where is Krishna, because Balaram was not seen, where is Krishna, searching. And he could not find, because already getting late, it was almost getting dark. Suddenly he got a nice breeze, nice fragrance of Tulsi. When he found the fragrance of Tulsi is there, then he moved toward that and saw Krishna was sitting under the Ashwatha Vriksha. And he just saw that Krishna is in 400 form, and he is surrounded by the Murtiman, all the weapons. And when he saw Krishna in that very unusual form, and very, because everybody is dead, Krishna is sitting like this. He is very sober and very gambhira, and he just fell at the feet and started crying. It started that now it is just like total darkness, and I am not in a position to understand what to do. Dwarka was saying, I am not feeling any peace. That when he was speaking, actually Dwarka came with his chariot, because he wanted to search for Krishna and go in that. So he left the chariot and came down to Krishna and speaking. When he was speaking, suddenly it so appeared that the chariot, till then he was driving, started flying off. Dwarka stand, the chariot with all the horses, Garuda Dhwaja, just started flying into the sky and disappeared. Dwarka was stunned. Because now no more required, because all the leelas are getting completed. Now Dwarka is not required, the chariot is not required, nothing is required. So everything Krishna is making in a most mysterious way. So that the devotees understand in a particular way, and non-devotees get confused more and more. That was his plan. So Dwarka, when he is speaking, he just came, and it is just flying like a rocket, just going up. And the Garuda Dhwaja went, and also followed the horses, everything went. And as it disappeared, and the Daruka suddenly saw the all the weapons which are surrounding Krishna, they also started disappearing. So first the chariot went up with horses and more. Then when he saw the Krishna was sitting, all the Shankarchakra, Gada, Padma, all the weapons are there, they also did, because they were in the in the personified form, they also all disappeared. He was just stunned. He was just completely stunned, because each and every scene, Krishna is not speaking but is performing. And he spoke something, Daruka spoke some few things, but Krishna's reply is only some action, making Daruka more and more get confused. Then after completing all the activity, then he said, "My dear Sarathi, now your duty is now go to Dwaraka and tell whatever happened." That's why Krishna allowed all these things. Otherwise, people may not be knowing, because Balaram went, all the people are dead, he is going, who will inform them? So he used Daruka as a messenger. "Daruka, please go to Dwaraka and tell them. And tell them that all the Yadu dynasty is killed, and they fought themselves and they killed, they are gone. Sankarsana Balarama has gone, and I am also living. You tell this, and you tell that that you and all the other people should not stay in Dwaraka, because in next 7 days it is going to be submerged. Nobody should stay there. So ensure that my wives and my parents, all people, other people should go in the protection of Arjuna to Indraprastha. Please, all of you travel there, and nobody should stay in Dwaraka, because it's going to be completely submerged." And Daruka said that you stay in my devotional path, and try to understand that whatever is happening, all my pastimes are created by. Strongly understand this, you will be situated in the peace. So by thinking in standard way, you stay peacefully. And Daruka understood, and he made circumambulation to Krishna 3 times and went to Dwaraka. The moment he went to Dwaraka, all the demigods, they came, like Shiva and Parvati, both of them came. Shiva, Parvati, Rishis, Prajapatis, Indra, along with Indra the Devata, Brahmaji, they all came to Krishna at Prabhasa Tirtha. Not only that, Pitu Devata, Rakshasa, Kinnara, Apsara, Garuda, and all they came. They wanted to see Krishna, because Krishna came very rarely. The Supreme Lord, Bhagavan Swayam, has come for the first time in one day of Brahma. And now they have seen so many activities. They wanted to see also how he really went to spiritual world. There must be great mystic things happening. They were eager to see. And many people, they stayed in the sky, in their aeroplanes. They are showering flowers that place. And when all the demigods came, Krishna just looked with all of them and closed his eyes. Just closed eyes, and mysteriously disappeared. Not that he just disappeared, and many people did not see what's happening. Even Brahma also could not see what's happening. But there are some great personalities. They could see how Krishna is traveling to the spiritual world. And because his body. Is Sachidananda. His body is Sachidananda. So it is a manifest form of eternity, knowledge, and bliss. So where is the question of leaving that? There is no question of that. So that's why other yogis, they use the yoga shakti, thereby they burn it and they leave the soul. But Krishna, there is no difference between body and the soul, and body is Sachidananda. So mysteriously, he entered. When he was traveling, only the when he was entering, nobody could see. Even Devata, Brahma, the Devi Devata, they could not see. Only great fortunate personalities, they could see. And they were trying. What happened? They're looking here and there, down, upstairs, but nothing was seen. They finally saw that Krishna is not there. So that at that time, Lord Shiva and Brahma, they felt, oh, really Krishna's activities are completely mysterious. That is whole purpose. When demigods and like Shiva and Devi Devata, like Shiva and Brahma, they come completely mesmerized. That it shows that Krishna's activity even mesmerized them. Then what to talk about the demonic people? That was his whole purpose, demonic purpose. And they saw that he is not there, he has gone, because all he told, he is going to go. And some people saw, and remaining people could not see what actually happened. And they saw finally he is not there. And they know very well that he has gone to his spiritual place. And at that time, Shukadeva Goswami started narrating a great statement. My dear Parikshit Maharaj, please try to understand one important point. He was saying that you should remember, you must be remembering that Krishna has brought the son of his spiritual master from Yamapuri. Do you remember this? And he has brought in the same form. It was dead long back, but in the same form he has brought. Remember that. And when you are dead, you are almost dead in the womb of your mother because of the Brahmastra, he also protected by entering into the womb of your mother. Definitely you remember this point. And he fought with Antakantaka, the Lord Shiva, and he even defeated Lord Shiva. He made him to sleep. Please remember this. And these are all much later, much earlier happened. And here he has seen that the person who tried to attack him unknowingly, the Jara hunter, he has sent him with the same body in the divine plane to the spiritual one. Just understand. And do you think that Krishna will be ineffective, will not be having power to protect himself? So never have this any thought. It is essentially to create, because devotees anyway know, it already information is there, he has to come, go. And also he wants to create a great confusion amongst the demoning people, because already they are confused, they want to create more confusion, because it's beyond anybody's comprehension. In a mysterious way he did it. And he said that anybody who is remembers, who wakes up in the morning, if they talk about or think about the mysterious way of Krishna going to spiritual abode, Sudhama Gamana, the person who thinks about it, to glorifies, he will surely go to spiritual. Shukadeva Goswami has given. Then meanwhile, the Daruka went to Dwaraka and he just fell at the lotus feet of Ugrasena and Vasudeva. Because Ugrasena is the king and Vasudeva is the father of Krishna. He went, fell, and he told each and everything happened. That all the people, the grandsons, sons, the people, everybody is dead. And he said that Krishna Balaram also left the abode. And they all came running, the entire, because now Krishna told that vacated. So all people came and they found all the relatives, everybody's dead, seen. But they could not see Krishna and Balaram because they are left with their body. When the Vasudeva, Rohini, Devaki, when they saw that they could not see Krishna, just they fell there and left the body. Because all the dead bodies are there, everybody is seen. But they could not see Krishna and Balaram. They just left the body. At that time, by design, Arjuna was there. That is Krishna's plan. That's why Arjuna went to Dwaraka, because Krishna's plan is there. It's going to happen. That's why he made him to think to come to Dwaraka and spend more time. That's why Yudhishthira Maharaj became, why Arjuna went so many days? What happened? Why is not coming? This, that, thinking. That's Krishna's plan. So we should be so confident that the moment we consider ourselves as instruments in hands of Krishna, and we have planned that we wanted to really perform for Krishna, and think like Yudhishthira Maharaj, I want to really spread the glories of Krishna. I want to really spread the glories of spiritual mass. I want to spread the glories of Srila Prabhupada in the footsteps of Yudhishthira Maharaj all over the world. If you think like that, you can be 100% sure that Krishna makes all the plans ready for you. This is what we should be understanding from Srimad Bhagavatam. And he made arrangement. He knows, Krishna knows that these things are going to happen. Then who will take care of? That's why he has made Arjuna to come. And when Arjuna saw, he even could not see Krishna. He could not see Balaram. But he saw all the people dead. Then he remembered the Bhagavad Gita. He remembered Bhagavad Gita. Because that is only solace. Because there is nobody even to console him. And he is left over with only ladies. All the ladies. Just imagine how much situation. So at that time he remembered Krishna's message of Bhagavad Gita. And tried, because if he also becomes like so much depressed, and then he cannot do other activity. Then because he is only left over male person in Dwaraka, then he did all the antyakriya, the final rites to all people. Yathavidya, then he has done. And also whatever to be done, also he made things, and then he traveled back with all the wives of Krishna. He traveled back to Mathura, and as Krishna mentioned, immediately after that, the Yadu dynasty destruction, exactly on 7th day, the entire Dwaraka except Krishna's palace, Krishna's main palace, everything is destroyed. Because Krishna, as a Madhusudana, is eternally, he resides in Mathura. Mathura is Dwaraka. Because Dwaraka, Vrindavanam, Dwaraka or Mathura are the eternal place for Krishna. So in Dwaraka, Krishna will be always there. And that's why the Dwaraka is very, very auspicious. Even by simply remembering Dwaraka, one will be free from all inauspiciousness. So then afterwards, Arjuna brought, as Krishna ordered, he has brought some people, Krishna already told in the beginning of Shankatirtha, he has sent some people, the children, the old people, and the ladies he has sent, and wives of Krishna in the Dwaraka. He took all of them and brought to Indraprastha. They brought the Dwaraprastha. In that, Krishna's grandson is also there. That is Vajranab. Vajranab is there. So he has put him as a king, Vajranab, to Mathura. He has just as a Rajabhishekta. And after doing that, Arjuna went to Indraprastha and informed Yudhishthira Maharaj about the complete annihilation. When they heard it, that we have heard this message of Krishna's departing to his spiritual, and everything destroyed, all the Pandavas, the made Parikshit Maharaj as king, and they also gone for Mahaprasthan. So Sukadeva Goswami finally says that the Lord Krishna's pastimes, especially they are very, very attractive and also very, very powerful. Especially his childhood pastimes are not only explained in Bhagavatam, it is explained in various other scriptures, and the person who happily glorifies it, sings the person, and such person will definitely attain the Parabhakti, means Paramabhakti, the topmost devotion towards Krishna, who is only the ultimate shelter of all Parama. So in this way we will come to today's conclusion of the third story, how Krishna has departed to the spiritual world in a most mysterious way, And this come to today's conclusion. And tomorrow we have today is third, so two more days and three more days. So next 2 days again we'll meet. Today with this story we have already reached 95 stories. We have completed few more stories we'll discuss. And Purnahuti is on 6th, that I mentioned. It will be at morning 10 o'clock. So I have reserved some stories, happy stories, rejoicing stories. Of course, Krishna's going speech also is a very astonishing story, which shows the great mystic power of Krishna. However, on the last day, we'll hear different stories. Thereby, we'll conclude and simply wait for the great auspiciousness to dawn on the earth for everybody's happiness and for our great delight. Srila Prabhupada ki, Srimad Bhagavatam Gantharaj ki, Gaur Premanand. Thank you.